Hi everyone and welcome to the channel. In this video, we'll be growing lettuce with hydroponics. We're gonna go from seed to harvest and look at every step involved, including just gathering my supplies. I wanted to film everything to show you how easy it is to grow hydroponic lettuce, and also to get an understanding for myself of what all the steps are, how long they take, and where we might be able to make improvements so that there's less human hours and effort going into that growing process. So far, I've just been gathering my supplies. I'm starting to fill this reservoir here, which we're going to use to start our seeds. You can see I've got these ice cube trays here, which have holes either punched or drilled into the bottom. We're just looking for room for water to go from that reservoir below up into the ice cube tray so that the plants will have access to water at all times. You can see that I'm breaking up my rock wool here. There's no need to use full cubes in the sizes that Grodan sells them. I've had lots of success just using small pieces of Grodan, and it drastically cuts down your cost per plant. These ice cube trays are going to lay within the lid. You can see I've cut a hole into the lids of these Tupperware containers. That ice cube tray can then sit inside, and I'm going to fill the reservoirs up to the point where that water level is just above the bottom of the ice cube tray. We want the Grodan inside to have access to that water. The Grodan is going to wick moisture throughout the entire piece of Grodan, and that's going to provide the water and moisture to your cedar plant. At this point, we are ready for our seeds. We can see that the Grodan is getting a bit darker. That's just a sign that these are saturated. They're soaking up the water from the reservoir below, which is what we want to see. Make sure that water can touch your rock wool. We want it to be wet. We want it to have constant access to that water throughout the germination process. Sowing these seeds is going to be pretty easy and straightforward. We really just want to set a seed or two on each piece of rock wool. For the sake of this speed run, I'm trying to do things as fast as I can, right? So I'm putting a few seeds on each one of these rock wool cubes, and I'm kind of rushing it. I would recommend just 1-2 max seeds per cube. For the most part, lettuce germinates pretty well. I was a little unsure if these seeds were going to work for me as they were getting old, so I overdid it. I've got a few seeds on each and every cube. I was really just rushing, trying to have a good time for this speed run, but ultimately I regret that, and you will see why in a couple of minutes. So put your seed on the cube. As long as the cube has access to water, it should germinate and we'll be off to the races. The last step of the seed starting process is just gonna be to put these reservoirs in the dark somewhere. So maybe you wanna put this in a closet. I simply cover my stuff up with a towel. Anything is fine. So this takes us to day number 3. My seeds have germinated and are beginning to sprout up. You probably wanna check your seeds once a day. Once they do germinate, we wanna move our reservoirs and the plants into light so that the seeds don't stretch themselves out and get weak. Here's what my plants look like at this point. Just beginning to spread out. The leaves haven't opened up yet, but we want to catch them early before they stretch too much. That brings us to day number 8. Our plants are looking pretty good here with the leaves opening up. We can see some color developing, and our stems are staying short. So if the stems of your plants are getting long and lanky, that's because your plant is still reaching, looking for more light. What doesn't look good though is that I have so many plants here. I only want one plant per piece of rock wool. That's all there's going to be room for as the plants start to grow. So I need to thin these plants out and remove the extra seedlings which have germinated here. This is what I was alluding to earlier, in that we probably only want to plant one seed per piece of rock wool to avoid this situation entirely. You can see that this is adding a lot of time to my speed run here. It's dead time that's not really productive and could be avoided if I was just a little smarter at the start. The other thing we'll want to check in on here is if all of our rock wool still has access to water from the reservoir. I've got a few pieces of rock wool that have dried out here, and that's not good. I did not realize this in real time, And as we fast forward a couple of days, those plants would dry out as well and eventually die. We want to make sure that the rockwool is able to touch the water, and that's going to keep it fully moist. By day 15, our plants are going to be looking for some nutrition. We haven't given them any yet. They've only had access to tap water. I'm going to be moving them into individual jars or reservoirs and starting a feeding program. I'm just filling each of these up with water. I've got a neck cup in place within each of these jars, and I'm going to fill up the reservoir until it goes up above the bottom of that neck cup. So once we put our plant inside, it will have access to the water and the roots will be submerged. This would end up taking a fair amount of time to fill up all of these reservoirs. Of course, that scales with how many lettuce plants you're trying to grow. Once the jars were full, we were ready to add nutrition to them. I'm going to be using the Advanced Nutrients Micro Grow Bloom series. It's a three-part nutrient series, very similar to other three-part nutrient series. It seems like every brand has, you know, a three-part base nutrient series. I think all of them are fine. I have had good success with this one in the past, so I continue to use it. I'm going to be putting 1 milliliter of each, the Micro Grow and Bloom, into each reservoir, and that's going to provide a full spectrum of nutrition for those plants. Once our individual reservoirs are set up, we can move our plants into them. We want to make sure that the roots are going to have access to the water and nutrients below. Depending on how big your roots are at this time, you may need to be pretty careful about this. It's helpful to pull out that neck cup and see where the water line was and make sure that your roots go down below that point. Once I've got the plant in, I typically still add a few more clay pebbles for support. Oftentimes people use these to block light getting down into the reservoir. That's not exactly helpful for me here as I have a few totally transparent reservoirs, but if you're trying to prevent algae, that's going to be a helpful way to do it. So this is pretty simple and easy, but it is time consuming. It added a lot of time to my speed run here and just the overall process of growing this lettuce. What we can do is start our seeds directly in individual jars. So following that same principle as earlier, we just need our rockwool piece to have access to water. That's going to keep it moist and allow our seeds to germinate. So it is possible to skip those early steps of the seed tray starter situation. You can jump right to individual reservoirs and save a bit of time and effort that way. I've been doing that in subsequent grows and it's been working quite well for me. Here we see the plants on day number 23. They're growing nicely and adding new leaves. There's really not too much work for us to do at this time to keep these plants growing. Things we might want to check in on are if each plant still has access to water. We want to make sure that the roots are partially submerged. And secondly, we might want to rearrange our plants depending on where our lighting source is or how it's situated, just to make sure each plant has equal access to light and is growing nicely. Skipping ahead to day number 31, our plants are looking pretty great in my opinion and growing strong. There's been little to no effort on my part to help keep these plants growing. All I've done is space them out a bit so that they're not overcrowding each other as they continue to grow. One other topic of note is algae, which is the result of light entering our reservoirs in nutrient solution. And that is the green stuff that we see growing in some of these reservoirs. There's a lot of concern about algae in the hydroponic community, which I think is generally overblown. As we scan these plants here, they all seem to be growing at similar paces, whether there's algae in the reservoir or not. With lettuce specifically, I don't think it matters too much. Most people will paint their jars or look for opaque reservoirs. Anything's fine. Use what you got. As our plants continue to grow and use up their water and nutrient solution, we eventually need to come back and top up those reservoirs. So I've pre-mixed water and nutrients in a jar, and I'm just going to go around and top up each of these plants. You don't want to fill them up too much. If you completely submerge the root system, you can drown the plant. It's good to leave a centimeter or an inch of roots exposed to air so that the plant can breathe. I did end up losing one of my plants. It appears as though I must have broken the stem of it while refilling the reservoir. I'm simply going to remove it from the garden. Just 5 days later, I needed to top up these reservoirs again. As the plants get bigger, they're going to require more and more water each day, and you need to stay on top of it to keep your plants hydrated. This brings us to day number 41, and it's harvest time. I'm going to be chopping all these plants down and harvesting their leaves for some delicious fresh salads. When you grow your own food, it tastes way better than what you're able to buy at the supermarket. That fresh taste is undeniable. Once I would finish harvesting, my timer was right around the 52 minute mark. There were a few things though not captured on camera, specifically mixing my nutrient solutions that I used to top up my reservoirs later on in the grow. That probably took less than 5 minutes, and I'm super comfortable saying that we went from seed to harvest with less than an hour of effort, which I think is pretty cool. There's a lot of room for improvement to cut down that time even further. And hopefully I've been able to show you within this video that it's easy and not very time consuming to grow hydroponic lettuce. I definitely recommend it. As mentioned, the harvests are great, it's not too hard, and it's a great introduction to a fun hydroponic hobby. Let me know your thoughts on these growing methods in the comments below. If you've got any additional tips or tricks or ways I might be able to speed things up, make it even easier, I would love to hear it and have that information shared with the community. Thanks a lot for watching, and happy harvesting!